Hey Dreamers! Welcome to our STEAMwork Sensory Play. I'm Barbara from National Children's Museum. We're so glad that you can join us. Did you know that the National Children's Museum was first founded in 1974? It was called the Capitol Children's Museum. It was located on H Street Northeast in Washington, D.C. for almost three decades before Congress designated it as the National Children's Museum, the one that you know right now and hopefully love today. Now, one of the most beloved experiences at the Capitol Children's Museum was the Bubble Room. And we can't wait for you to come back and see our new Bubble Zone at the new location at 1300 Pennsylvania Avenue as soon as it's safe to do so. But until that happens, we want to help you make bubbles at home. Our recipe calls for 4 cups of warm water, 1/2 cup of sugar, and 1/2 cup of dishwashing liquid. We're gonna put all of those things together. We're gonna show you how to do it, and then we'll be able to make bubbles right here at home. I was able to warm up some of my water in my tea kettle. There are other ways of warming up water. Just make sure you're doing it with an adult. When we put our cups of water in a container, this is a great opportunity to talk about measurement, proportions, fractions, right? So if we're having to make 4 cups, that also equals 1 quart. How many 1/2 cups would that be? How many 1/4 cups would that be? I'm gonna open up my sugar. Get 1/2 cup. So we have our warm water, we have our sugar. We're gonna have to mix it. We wanna make sure that the sugar dissolves entirely before we put in the dish soap. We've gotten all that sugar. It's pretty good. So now, our very precious dish soap. Okay. This looks like it's gonna be great bubble solution. Now, we wanna let it sit for a little bit. And while we're waiting, a great activity or a great idea to do is to look for bubble wands around the house. Maybe you already have some bubble wands, you just need some extra bubble juice, but maybe you don't have anything at home. But it's wrong. You actually have lots of ideas and lots of potential objects that can be used as bubble wands at home. So I'm gonna look around the house and I'm gonna show you what I came up with. I found a masher, found a grater, found a toy, found some more toys. I found a cookie cutter. I also found some string. So we can make different shapes using this string, and this can actually make some really big bubbles. I have something from my papa. Even found some mesh. So what are we looking for? What do all these objects have in common? We're looking for something that has a hole, right? And it might be squares, it could be circles and ovals, could even be a star shape. Doesn't really matter, as long as it's fully enclosed all the way around, and there's a way for us to be able to hold it and blow. Okay, should we test it out? See which one works? What should we try first? I'm thinking we can try a star. Okay, so I'm gonna dip my star in. My fingers are gonna get a little bit sticky, but I can see it's working, so. Excellent! We made a bubble. It even bounced on the counter, which is very cool. Now, so this is working. This is great. So a cookie cutter, 2 thumbs up. How about our grater? Just have to figure out how to blow. One more time. This one might be a little bit tricky because it's hard to blow the air through it. Should I try a masher? Let's see what else can I do. I kind of want to try this, the mesh, right? What happens when I use this? I'm not even sure how to do it. I'm just gonna try and play. That's awesome. Do you see all the bubbles that I just made? This is so cool. Now, I wanted to try some string. This might be the last one that we tried together, but I encourage you to keep trying and see what objects can work. So this one isn't closed yet. Maybe we can tie it, right? Make some kind of loop. Okay, so now I have a loop, now it's closed. This might be too big, I don't know. One other fun bubble activity that we can do, if you have food coloring at home and you want to make lots of different bubble container solutions, so you make your big batch and then you make it into smaller containers, you can add food coloring to each one. You can use some of your homemade bubble wands or your plastic ones that you might have bought at a store, and you can make bubble painting, and we'll help you figure out how to do that at home with some extra resources. But you basically use your different color bubble solution and you blow your bubbles out of paper, and that becomes your bubble painting. So lots of cool ideas, lots of things you can do and play with. We hope you're having fun. We hope you're learning at home. Don't forget that STEAMwork makes the dream work. Tune in tomorrow for your Climate Action Hero Challenge. Bye-bye.